self-driving vehicles will be here soon. However, it's not that one day, right, suddenly, you know, all the vehicles will change from non-self-driving to self-driving. You know, the adoption, mass adoption is going to take, you know, a long time. And basically, I'm bringing new AI technology to solve this problem forever. My name is Raquel Ortasun, and I'm the founder and CEO of Wabi, as well as a full professor at the University of Toronto. I did my doctorate at EPFL, my PhD at EPFL, in 2006. And from there, I went to MIT and Berkeley for my postdocs. I decided to start my own business because the industry in self-driving was consolidating to an approach that really is having a hard time to solve the problem. And in order to bring, you know, the next level of technology to the market, the best thing is to start afresh, and that's why I started my own company. One of the things that I realized that was important is to be working with industry as well as academia, because when you work in a field like self-driving, you need industry, you need a large program, you need engineering resources to really understand what are the problems that you need to solve, that you need to research about, and which ones are already solved. The challenges that the industry in self-driving is facing is that, you know, despite 2 decades since the DARPA challenge, the solution doesn't exist yet. So there's definitely a need for innovation to come up with that solution that will finally, you know, be able to handle all the difficult situations that arise, you know, as you are driving. So that's, I would say, one challenge. And the second challenge is that, you know, we are bringing a product to market, right? And people need to use this product. For me, self-driving is really an obsession. It's a very, very difficult problem to solve. And as a scientist, I'm really drawn to problems that don't have a solution yet. At the same time, this part is a bit more personal, which is that, you know, I know too many people that have had traffic accidents that have affected their lives. So I definitely want to bring, you know, safety to our roads. And I want to do something with my life that really transforms the world and, you know, has my legacy. And this is where I think self-driving definitely is going to change the world as we know it today. My studies at EPFL really prepared me for the challenge ahead. And in particular, I think the most important thing was I learned how to learn. I learned how to do research and learn how to innovate. And that has been extremely, extremely useful throughout my career. Being a female in a male-dominated field is never easy. Oftentimes, we need to do 10 times more to be recognized. Despite this, it's very, very important that no matter what happens, you never give up, because you know you're worth it and you're going to transform the world. So keep going.